One of the most important types of solutions to a dynamical system is also the simplest, a solution in which nothing at all happens. We call this type of solution an equilibrium. We illustrate an equilibrium with an example. Let x sub t plus 1 equals 2 times x sub t minus 1. In this dynamical system, we first double the number, then subtract 1. What is the number that, if you double it and then subtract 1, you get back to where you started? There's only one number that satisfies this condition, the number 1. The number 1 is an equilibrium of the dynamical system, x sub t plus 1 equals 2 times x sub t minus 1. Let's demonstrate that this is true. If we start with the initial condition, x sub 0 equals 1, we plug it into the formula for x sub 1 to calculate that x sub 1 equals 1. That looks good. We stayed at 1 for one time step. To be in equilibrium, x sub t has to stay at 1 forever. Will x sub 2 also be 1? Plugging in x sub 1 equals 1 to the formula for x sub 2 gives the same calculation, showing that x sub 2 stays at 1. In fact, we get the same calculation for any value of t. We can keep going like this forever. If we were patient, we could calculate that x sub 100 equals 1, or even x sub 1000 equals 1. We say that the solution x sub t equals 1 is an equilibrium of the dynamical system x sub t plus 1 equals 2 times x sub t minus 1. For this equilibrium solution, no matter the value of t, x sub t is always 1. We can show that x sub t equals 2 is not an equilibrium by trying the initial condition x sub 0 equals 2. If x sub 0 is 2, we'd calculate that x sub 1 is 3. If we start at 2, we don't stay at 2, so 2 is not an equilibrium. To determine if a number is in equilibrium, just plug it into the dynamical system. If you get the same number back, it is in equilibrium. If you get a different number back, it is not in equilibrium. Let's look at another example, this time in difference form. Z sub n plus 1 minus z sub n equals 4 times the quantity z sub n minus 2 times the quantity zn plus 3. Let's try the initial condition z sub 0 equals 2. We set n equals 0 into the dynamical system and replace z sub 0 with 2. The right-hand side becomes 0, so that z sub 1 minus 2 equals 0, or z sub 1 is 2. We started at 2 and we stayed at 2. Z sub n equals 2 is an equilibrium of the dynamical system. We also find that negative 3 is an equilibrium. Again, the right-hand side becomes 0, so that z doesn't change. Z sub n equals negative 3 is an equilibrium of the dynamical system. If you try any other initial condition, z sub 0, you will find that z sub 1 will be a different number. For example, if z sub 0 equals 0, then z sub 1 equals negative 24. 0 is definitely not an equilibrium. This approach of plugging in numbers works well at testing if a number is in equilibrium. It's not a great way to find the value of an equilibrium if we don't know it. We can't test every single number out there. Let's hope we can find a better approach for finding equilibria.